Now Wesley's keeping Magnus waiting. We do have the first move on the board, though. Wesley opens with his king's pawn. In the last final, back in February, when these two met, Wesley had a lot of success with his king's pawn.
He did.
Following openings, he had recommended on a chessboard course, but meanwhile, Magnus opening with his king's pawn as well. In reply, will we see Wesley do something we've seen him play before? Or does he have a surprise in store for Magnus?
Well, this is already a move that he recommended in his own chessboard course. And now, if the queen's pawn moves two squares, that is his course recommendation. So this is going to be fascinating stuff.
Yeah, the first time round. So this is the Italian game. It's a very direct way of playing the Italian game. But first time round, a few months ago, Wesley won this position against Magnus Carlsen. I do think Magnus won't be surprised this time round, however.
Narrative
Magnus will have done his homework.
White has an edge. What we saw there was David being ice cold and saying, actually, there's no threat. And my reaction, actually, of trading queens was simply a reaction to something that would happen if I'm objective three moves later. So it's very, very important. Don't be emotional when you're playing a game of chess. Definitely don't let your emotions get the better of you. And be ice cold and just look at the position. Be totally objective, and it's difficult to do, actually.
It's finding a balance as well, because sometimes if you do see your opponent's threat, sometimes it does take you two or three moves to stop it, and that threat is only coming in two or three moves' time, so you have to stop it immediately in advance before it even does materialize on the board. So, it's good to be aware of your opponent's threats and how urgent it is to defend immediately against them. That's what Wesley So is weighing up in his mind right now. Does he need to capture that black bishop with his knight now, or can he delay it maybe a few moves and keep Magnus guessing? Personally, I would just take that bishop off, as he has done. That bishop was just too well placed.
And I'm curious now how he will react. And he is a super grandmaster for a reason, and there he just calmly walks his queen one square forward. Could not have dreamt of that move at all. I mean, to me, it's just like, it removes the connection from the queen getting to the right.
It's highly surprising, right, that Wesley has pushed his queen up there. He's going after Magnus, push his pawn one square further just to loosen up White's king shelter even more. There we go. Yeah, I mean, this is, we've said in the past, it is kind of alpha zero influenced by AI, this type of idea with black, but it's just good chess. It's just pushing a pawn, weakening your opponent's king, using the pawn as a battering ram. Now Wesley So takes a pawn, but that pawn looks irrelevant. White's queen is just not joining the action.
We got an explosive move, David. We have a tactic on the board. Magnus is willing to sacrifice a knight just to open up the white king position.
Not just
it's going to be checkmate. We have to show this, mate.
Yeah, we will go back and show this. Actually, Magnus was ready to sacrifice his queen if something different had happened there. But okay, Wesley trying to trade off a set of rooks, but that's not going to help him. Magnus pushing a pawn, White's rook has to move, and then it's just going to be checkmate. Wesley, so he's either losing a rook or he's getting checkmated. He just resigns.
Wow, what a dramatic start to the final. Magnus Carlsen almost getting a checkmate.